The gruesome attack during early morning prayers rocked the nation.
We are in the midst of a terrorist assault focused on Jerusalem.
After the attack, Israel's public security minister announced he'd make it easier for Israelis to carry weapons for self-defense. It's designed to help Israelis protect themselves and also cope with the growing fear that an attack could happen anytime, anywhere.
This is my life. I live here. I can't think about it a lot because it will just stop me from going places, so I'm trying to put it behind, sort of.
The Jewish people have been going through these type of things for thousands of years already, and our only real choice is to fight the darkness with light and choose life.
The two terrorists were from Jabal Mukabir, an eastern Jerusalem neighborhood that gave them access to Israeli social services, the entire city and country. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said the terrorists were full of deep hatred and incitement against the Jewish people and the Jewish state. But he warned Israelis against taking the law into their own hands.
We're in a lengthy war against abhorrent terrorism, which did not start today. Terrorism has followed us through all the years of the Zionist enterprise. We have always withstood it, and we will do so this time as well.
Following the attack, the Palestinian Authority issued contradictory messages. Some analysts believe Secretary of State John Kerry pushed PA President Mahmoud Abbas into condemning the attack. His advisor, Sultan Abu al-Anain, praised the attack as a heroic operation. And his political party, Fatah, announced they would hand out candy in celebration of the Jerusalem operation. It was the worst terror attack in Jerusalem since 2008. Four rabbis were killed, three of them dual American Israeli citizens. A policeman died later from wounds sustained in the gun battle with the terrorists. Yitzhak Heshing was injured in the attack.
Everyone, everywhere is in danger, not just in Jerusalem, but everywhere. I think that what is happening is a very crazy situation.
President Obama condemned the attack and said it was a tragedy for both the U.S. and Israel. Despite what many see as Palestinian incitement, he said the U.S. wanted to help bring peace.
The United States wants to work with all parties involved to make that a reality and to isolate the kinds of extremists that are bringing about this terrible carnage.
In the meantime, Netanyahu said Israel would step up law enforcement and stiffer punishments for those who incite and increase security on the streets of Jerusalem. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.